Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can print these two patterns. So here you can see first pattern is printing digits and second pattern is printing alphabets. So here you can also notice these digits are increasing as well as they are decreasing in the pattern, right? So before start, I am going to share one detail with you. So if you go to the detail of this video, you will find links of playlist links of various programming related videos. So do follow them so that you can have various videos related to programming languages. So now after this information, I'm going to start to explain how you can implement the logic and code related to these patterns in C programming. So first I'm going to explain this one. So here you can see total number of rows are 5 and number of rows that you want to print can be available in any number. So for example, right now we are taking a variable whose value will be 5. Further, you can read this value from user, like how many number of rows you want to print. So I am taking as 5. So now I am going to tell you how many loops are required to print this pattern. So our first loop will be to print, or you can say to control on which number of row we are currently. So first loop will be for rows, right? Now we need to identify which will be the second loop. So here you can see we have some spaces to be printed. So if you see it carefully, so on the left hand side, we need to print these number of spaces. So in first row, we have 4, then 3, then 2, then 1, and then 0. Why it is starting from 4? Because number of rows are 5. If number of rows are more, then it will start from n minus 1, right? So we can implement the logic with the help of this. So second loop will be for space. Then here you can see if I divide it from here, so these all digits are printing in increasing order, and after this line, all the digits are printing in decreasing order. So third loop will be for printing numbers in increasing order, and fourth loop will be for printing numbers in decreasing order. So these four loops are required. So now after this requirement, I am going to write a program for this implementation so that you can understand how it will look like. So I am removing these. So now I am writing all the requirement here. So first loop will be for rows, second loop will be for printing spaces, then third is for increment, and fourth is for decrement order, right? So I wrote here this thing so that you can remember, like we need to implement four things. So first I'm going to implement first loop, that is for rows. So in place of n, I am directly using 5 here. So 5 means 5 number of rows to be printed. Then I need to implement the loop for space. So now we are going to identify the condition for this. So here you can see first we need 4 spaces, then 3, then 2, then 1, and then 0. So this we can identify through this 5 minus I. So here you can see I will be 1 first time. So 5 minus 1, it will provide 4. Then second rotation, I will be 2. So here it will be 5 minus 2. So we can use this condition for implementing second loop. So I am using this here. And inside this loop, I am going to print space. So here, remember one thing. Inside these double quotes, you need to press a space bar one time so that spaces can be printed. And then I am closing this, right? So let's say value of I is 1. So control will go to here to check the condition. If condition is true, then this loop will repeat. So here condition is 5 minus I. So I is 1. So it will repeat 4 times, so 4 spaces will be created. Then when I will become 2, so it will be 5 minus 2. So 3 spaces will be created. So after completion of this program, I'm going to explain this whole thing so that you can understand how it is printing. So let me implement two more loops, one for increment and one for decrement. So after completion of this loop, I am taking one more variable, that is m, and let's say I am starting it from 1. So initial value of m is 1. Now I am implementing one more loop, which is k starting from 1, then k less than equals to I, and k plus plus. Inside this loop, I am going to print %d k plus plus. So here I am using post in Here I have to use m. In place of m, I wrote k by mistake. So here I am using m plus plus. So it is post increment. So first m will be printed, and then its value will be incremented. So here I close this loop. After this loop, I am writing m equals to m minus 2, right? And then I am implementing one more loop. So this was the third loop for increment. And now I am going to implement fourth loop, which is for decrement. So this is l equals to 1. L less than equals to I, and L plus plus. So here notice it carefully, it is L less than I, only less than, not less than equals to. And inside this loop, I am going to print value of M, but I am using M minus minus, right? And this loop is closed here. Now, just after closing this loop, I am using one more printf that will be for backslash n, and then you can close this for loop, right? So after completion of this fourth loop, you need to print a backslash n, and then you need to close this curly brace. So now I think it is visible to you. So after completion of this L for loop, printf is written, which is for backslash n, and then here you can see this for loop is complete. So this is one loop, outer loop, and it is having three more loops. So this is second one, which is inner loop. This is third one, which is also inner loop, and this is fourth one, which is also inner loop. Now I am going to explain from the beginning so that you can understand how it is printing. So here I am going to use all the variables. So first time I is 1, right? So starting from here, then we need to check the condition. Then control will transfer to this loop, right? J is starting from 1. Now check this condition, 5 minus I. So what is the value of 5? It is 1. So 5 minus 1 is 4. So how many times this loop will repeat? It will repeat 4 times. So 4 spaces will be printed, right? Now it will terminate, and control will be here, m equals to 1. So initially m is 1 now. Now go to this loop. So it is k equals to 1, k less than equals to I. So what is the current value of I? It is 1. So how many times this loop will repeat? It will repeat 1 time only. So it will print value of m. So it is post increment. So first value of m will be printed, and then it will be incremented. So it will print 1, it will print 1, and then m will become 2. And how many times we need to repeat this loop? Only 1 time. So in one rotation, m is printed and then it is incremented. So this is called a one rotation. If we talk about two rotations, so first m will print, then it will increment first rotation, then m will print again and it will increment. So this will be called second rotation. that we are going to do when I will become 2. So now I hope you understood. One time m is printed, that is 1, and m is incremented by 1, so it is 2. And this loop executed one time. Now control will transfer to this statement m equals to m minus 2. So current value of m is 2, so it will become 0. Then we come to this loop. So here check the condition l less than I. So what is l? 1. What is I? 1. So 1 less than 1, false. So first time when I is 1, so this loop will not execute. And we don't want to do this because after 1 we don't want to print anything. And after completion of this loop, printf slash n will take place. So slash n means new line. So this line is printed. And now we are here to print this second loop. Right? So after completion of this statement, we will move here, I plus plus. So this time I will become 2. This time I will become 2. So it means this whole cycle is executing for second time. Now we will be here. So j will again start from 1. Check the condition 5 minus I. So I is now 2. So 5 minus 2 is 3. So how many times this loop will repeat? 3 times only. And how many spaces are required? 3. So this is fulfilled. So I hope you understood this now. Now at this place m will be 1 again. So you need to assign 1 to m again. Then execute this loop. So right now I is 2. Right now I is 2. So how many times this loop will repeat? 2 times. Right? So we need to print m, then we need to increase it. So I already told you, printing of m and increment of m by 1 is one rotation. So m is printed, so it will print 1, and after printing it will be 2. After printing it will be 2. So right now we have performed only one rotation of k. Then again k will execute, so m will be printed, so m will print 2 because its current value is 2. So 2 will be printed and it will become 3. So m printed 1, then it incremented to 2, so one rotation. Then m printed value 2, then it incremented to 3, so it is second rotation. So this way this loop executed 2 times and the last value of m is 3. So this is important. Now m equals to m minus 2, it will be 1. So now you will understand why I started it from 1 here and why I decremented it by 2 from here. So this time we are on this loop. So value of I is 2. Value of I is 2. And L is 1. So 1 less than 2. Condition is 2. So this loop will repeat first time. So it will print M. So what is the current value of M? Is 1. And what we require? 1. So 1 will be printed. And after printing, it will decrease it to 0. And how many times this loop will repeat? Only 1 time. Because I is 2 and L is 1. And we have less than. When L will be 2 and I is also 2, this loop will terminate and nothing will print it. So again we came here for new line. So 2 rotations of this whole cycle is completed. Now third rotation. So I will be incremented to 3. I will be incremented to 3. Then check this condition 5 minus 3. It is now 2. So 2 spaces will be printed. So here you can see we require 2 spaces. Then m equals to 1. So again m will start from 1. Now I hope you can easily execute this one. So I is 3. So this loop will repeat 3 times. This loop will repeat 3 times. So 3 times means 3 times m will be printed and along with it will be incremented. So initial value of m is 1. So here you can see 1 is printed and m became 2. So this is first rotation. Then again m will print and it will increment itself to 3. So this is second rotation. Then again m will print and it will increase itself to 4. So this is third rotation. So this way 3 times m printed and it incremented itself. So after completion of this loop, what is the final value of m? Is 4. and 1, 2, 3 also printed. Now you will understand how we did this and why minus minus is here. So after completion of this loop, m equals to m minus 2. So m will become 2, right? Now we came here. This time I is 3. So how many times this loop will repeat? It will repeat 2 times. So first it will print value of m. So value of m is 2. So 2 will be printed here. Now we want 1. So after printing 2, m will become 1 because minus minus is here. So printing of m and its decrement is one step. Similarly, we did here. So we printed 2 and decremented it to 1. So one rotation is completed. Now we need to repeat it again. So m will be printed. So 1 is printed on screen and it will move to 0. So this way, I hope you understood how these patterns are printing. So I explained you how these four loops are collaborating together to print the pattern for these digits. Right? Now, as we printed this, now we need to print these alphabets. So you need to do a small change only and everything will be printed. So I request you to implement this code first and put main, so put this whole code inside main, declare the required variable. So you will have this. After printing this, do a minor change and test whether I told you correctly or not. So after that minor change, this pattern will be converted into this. So what you need to do this only. You need to start M with A and you need to enclose it in single quotes. And the data type of M for this is character. So here you need to declare this M like this. Int M for this pattern, right? And for this pattern, you need to declare M as cap, right? So by doing this minor change, you will be able to print this pattern. And here you can see M increment is done, M decrement is done. So don't worry about this. So whenever we increase any alphabet, it automatically increases its ASCII value. And accordingly, result will be printed. Now, if we are taking M as character variable, so we need to change the format specifier as well. So here, in case of %D, you need to use %C so that proper alphabet will be printed. So increment decrement will be done in ASCII value, but if you want to print the corresponding alphabets, then you can use %C, right? So I hope this way you will be able to convert both the patterns. And this code is for that purpose. I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you like this video, you can open my channel, go to playlist, and on after going to playlist, you will see various playlists related to various programming languages are available on my channel. So I uploaded more than 1,000 videos on my channel related to computer programming. So do watch them and follow my YouTube channel so that it can be popular. I hope whatever I explained in this video, you understood. So thank you and keep watching my videos. Thank you.